Throughout its long history, the Jedi Order had countless enemies, ranging from Darksiders who wished to destroy them, to petty thieves who attempted to steal the priceless artifacts kept secure within the Jedi Temple. So when they captured their enemies alive, what did the Jedi do with them afterwards? Within the Jedi Temple itself, there was a detention center where most prisoners of the Order were sent to, either temporarily or permanently, depending on their crimes. Constructed during the ancient Great Sith War and the Jedi Civil War, the temple's detention center was specifically built to contain powerful force users. As such, the complex was reinforced with lightsaber and force-resistant materials to ensure that even the most powerful force users wouldn't be allowed to escape. Additionally, a ray shield covered the outer chambers as an added protection, along with a constant security team on guard to monitor the prisoners locked within. With such advanced security measures in place, the detention center was nearly impossible to escape from without outside help. Full-fledged Sith Lords, to even their dark side-created beasts, were often kept securely within the prison, usually permanently, as the Jedi refused to release them to Republic security, fearing their public prisons would not be able to contain such powerful beings. Although it was a prison, the Jedi Order made sure its prisoners were treated humanely, with the cell blocks being treated as living quarters. They were outfitted with comfortable seating and bedding arrangements, hollow entertainment devices, and bathrooms that were the only place the prisoners could find any privacy from the constant monitoring. During the centuries when the Sith were thought to have gone extinct, the temple's detention center was primarily used for thieves and Jedi Padawans, who had broken the Order's rules. For outside thieves, they were temporarily kept at the prison, where they would undergo interrogation before being transferred off to the Republic's own prison system. For the Padawans, they too were typically kept at the detention center temporarily, until their respective master would return and give them a suited punishment for their misbehavior. It wouldn't be until the start of the Clone Wars when the Jedi would require another place to keep its prisoners, as the galactic-wide conflict saw a great influx of dangerous criminals and Separatist-aligned commanders that would be captured by the Order. The most dangerous of the prisoners of war were instead transferred to a highly secured location in the galaxy and kept at a complex known as the Prism. With its location only being known to the Jedi Council, along with it being located within the chaotic wild space region of the galaxy, the Prism was perhaps the most locked down and secret prison in the entire galaxy at that time. The space station housed 208 prisoners by the end of the war, most of whom were dark side users who had aligned with the Separatists, or were highly skilled assassins that were too high of a risk to be kept anywhere else. Guarded by 100 security droids and overseen by a single Jedi Master, the Prism was entirely self-sustaining, with its prisoners' day-to-day activities being managed by the space station itself, rather than any living staff. On top of the Prism's state-of-the-art security systems, it also contained one of the top medical facilities in the entire galaxy, likely to ensure that if the prisoners ever fought one another, they could easily be kept alive until their awaited trials after the war. The fate of both the Jedi Temple's detention center and the Prism both came under the control of the Galactic Empire, in which the prisoners were either killed off or forced to serve Emperor Palpatine, as was the case at least with those stationed on the Prism, who were released under the condition that they would aid Darth Vader and his Sith Master to retake control of the Imperial capital world of Coruscant during a short coup undertaken by some disgruntled officers. While the fate of the Prism is unknown after its capture by the Empire, the Jedi Temple's detention center on Coruscant was left abandoned even after the new Jedi Order took control of it again, with it only being put back into use decades later when the temple was eventually rebuilt and put to full use during the Dark Nest Crisis.